Praise the Lord. We want to welcome you to our midweek service. I am George Maina Wambogo. I am born again. Wherever you are watching, you are very much welcome. Our reading word comes from the book of 1 Peter, chapter 1, verse 3. And it says, Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy, he has given us new birth into a living hope. Given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. Praise and worship. You can take this session.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
Praise be to God again.
Amen.
Just urge us to rise up as we enter into the courts of the Lord. And just in the confines of where we are, I hope that you may be able to just praise with us. Make your heart just be free to just sing for the Lord, because I think this is a time to just focus on Him other than other things that are within us and our environments. Amen? So let's keep our hearts ready. For hands.
Unto Jesus, for he cares for you. Cast your burdens unto Jesus, for he cares. Cast your burdens unto Jesus, for he cares. Cast your burdens unto Jesus, for he cares.
God will make a way where there seems to be no way. He will walks in ways we cannot see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me closely to His side. With love and strength for each new day, He will make a way.
That He'll make a way for us, because He's King of Kings, He's the Lord of Lords. Love and strength,
love and strength for each new day. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me closely to His side. With love and strength. For each new day, He will make a way. He will make a way.
Mighty and everlasting Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we want to worship You and honor Your name, O King of Kings, as we declare with our lips, O my Father, we're going to make our way where seems to be no way, dear God. You are so gracious, Abba God, that have taken care upon us, O Jehovah God, since Sunday. In the middle of the week, Jehovah God, want to declare of Your faithfulness, Abba Redeemer. We want to adore You and approve to Your name on high, O God. As we approach the throne of mercy this afternoon, O God, with a heart full of repentance, that Abba God Almighty may sweep over us, O God, and make us worthy before Your presence, O God Almighty. We appreciate You and give You praise for Your forgiveness, O God Almighty. We surrender all unto King of all the glory. We surrender, King of Almighty, them that are sick and unwell, O Jehovah God, and to able ones, because Your name is Jehovah Rapha. Stretch Your holy hand upon them, O King of all glory. Even a time like now, as a nation, O God Almighty, we are through, God Almighty, through a pandemic disease, how we trust upon Your healing power, O King of all glory. You make a way where seems to be no way, dear Lord. Even a time like now of the COVID-19, dear Lord, we trust, Abba Father, in making a way for Your own glory upon our nation, O Jehovah God. We surrender, God Almighty, the people in Mendex, O Jehovah God, them that are in hospitals and working there, O God, unto Your able hands. The number, God, we want to safeguard them, O King of all glory, even upon this disease, in the mighty name of Jesus. Them that are unwell, O God Almighty, stretch Your holy hand upon them, O King of all glory. We commit our families unto You, King of all glory. The number, God, we want to watch over our families wherever they are, O dear Lord. Even at times, Jehovah God, that we are celebrating this week, O God, about the Father's Day, Jehovah God. We commit them unto Your hands, O God. Time like now, when our economy has gone down, O Father, You are still on Your throne, dear Father. Upload them, O Father, with Your light, righteous hand, O King of all glory. We thank You and worship Your name, O my Father. Even for the church of God, dear Lord, the church that You bought the price, O God, of the blood of Jesus Christ at the cross of Calvary. We declare, dear Lord, that my Father and my God, no gates of hell shall prevail upon Your church, O my Father. Even at time like now, when the doors of the churches are closed, O God, we trust You, King of all glory, that Your church shall not go through shame, my Father. Even the people that have entrusted as a nation, O God, to walk through all the churches are going to be opened, my Father. We want to believe, God, that we want to make our will, King of all glory. And my Father, when You give us another chance to come back and worship You, honor and glory shall turn back unto You. We surrender all unto You, King of all glory. We pray, God, we want to watch over Your people, watch over the members of this church, O King of Almighty, wherever they are. Safeguard them, O King of all glory. Hide them under Your wings. We thank You for our reverend, O King of all glory, Francis. Francis, who is overseer of this parish. God Almighty, continue to watch over him together with his family. Uplift him, O King of all the glory. We thank you and honor your name, O Jehovah God. We declare and decree, dear Lord, that you are bringing us back to this altar. Save and sound all of us, O King of all glory. We thank you, we worship your name. Have your way today, O King of all glory. Even as we hear of your word, O my Father, minister to us, O King of all glory. Them that are downcast their spirits, O God Almighty, uplift them, O King of all glory. Them that are discouraged, O God Almighty, and encourage them, O King of all glory. Them that have no hope, O God, as your word comes, O King of all glory. Speak a word of hope, O my Father. We worship and honor your name, dear Lord, that in many days of the week, watch over us, O King of all glory. And you give us another chance on Sunday, Lord Almighty, you have your word. All the glory and honor that will turn back unto you. We give you praise and we give you honor, O God. We cover every prayer that we've offered before you with the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray and we give thanks. Amen. Let's share together our Lord's prayer. Our Father, we start in heaven. Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us to temptations, but deliver us from all evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
We hear a reading from 1 Peter chapter 1, and it is from verses 3 to 9. I to read, I'm Ruben Kimodo Gedoi, Jesus Christ is my Lord and Savior. Again, 1 Peter chapter 1, and it is verse 3 up to 9. Can we read together? Praise be to God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. In his great mercy, he has given us new birth into a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, and into an inheritance that can never perish, spoil or fade in heaven, spoil or fade kept in heaven for you, who through faith are shielded by God's power until the coming of the salvation that is ready to be revealed in the last time. In this, you greatly rejoice, though now for a little while you may have to suffer grief in all kinds of trials. These have come so that your faith, of greater worth than gold, which perishes even though refined by fire, may be proved genuine and may result in praise, glory, and honor when Jesus Christ is revealed. Though you have not seen him, you love him, and even though you do not see him now, you believe in him and are filled with inexpressible and glorious joy. For you are receiving your goal of your faith, the salvation of your souls. That is all the word of God. May his name be glorified.
To greet you all in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. He is my Savior. We want to thank God that he has given us this mid-week service. And in it, we want to increase our hope as we move on, because God is calling us the hope that is alive, hope that is not dwindling in any way, but hope that is very expectant. Let us stand and sing hymn number. Hymn, my hope is built on nothing less than Jesus Christ, my righteousness. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus Christ, my righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but hold it in on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. When darkness wears his lovely face, I rest on his unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the veil. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. His oath is covered, none is brought, support me in the whelming flood. When all around my soul gives way, he then is all my hope and stay. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. You are the only ground that is firm, that is stable. All other grounds, Lord, is sinking sand. Help us at this particular hour. Help us at this particular time to anchor unto you, who is the firm, the rock that we need to stand on. Even when the storms are so many, when we are anchored on you, mighty Father, we know that we will stand and we will be able to get victory. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Brethren, we want to thank God that He is still holding us. He has seen us this far. We have spent about 3 months now before we meet, even in the sanctuary. But we still hold hope. Our hope is living, that one of these days we are coming back. And we know our coming back will be even better than the way we were even before, because the Lord talks about making things new. And we are grateful to God that He has promised to make things new. Brethren, crushed, devastated, fear and torn out, these are waves of feelings that wash over the suffering and threatening the visions that people hold. The book of Peter, the letter to Peter, was written to a group of believers who were going through hard times, difficult times. On that first of last month, that is May, we celebrated the day of Pentecost. And we reminded ourselves that that was the day when the church was born. Many people who had come to Jerusalem left for their homes. We want to thank God that they carried the word with them. They carried the word with them. And the church started now to go far and wide. Again, during the same time, if you read Acts, from Acts chapter 3 onwards, up to about Acts chapter 16, 17, you find that they erupted some kind of persecution. And it was not one, it was not two, many. They made people to disperse, again, far and wide. And they were able even to go to the Gentile world, so that the church was born even in the Gentile world. So even when there are calamities and there are hardships, we still find the church growing and going on and on. So Peter wrote this epistle because he wanted to comfort. He wanted to encourage. He wanted to offer hope to that kind of people who were undergoing this kind of difficulty. They are suffering trials and troubles. And whatever is happening to us today, whatever is happening to the world today, is not different from what was happening by then. So I take that this letter, again, sweet each one of us, and our condition as we are today, that it is coming to encourage, to comfort, and even to rekindle our hope in him. There are three things that these verses are telling us, and we want to learn from them, because the verses that we have read, verses 3 to 9, they are the verses that hold that living hope we are talking about. Number one, the strength of our hope. Jesus, who resurrected from the grave, becomes the strength of our hope. And therefore, the strength of our hope is the resurrection of Jesus Christ. If he never resurrected, then even the message that we always preach would have been in vain. But because he resurrected, and there is no other person who had resurrected, it makes all the difference. We have a living hope in Christ, who defeated death, he conquered Satan and everything else, and we are on his side, and therefore we have that living hope, that expectant hope, and we want to hold to that even when we are undergoing some trials and difficulties. A hope is only as strong as its basis. Christ is the basis of our hope, and Christ is strong, the strength of our life, and therefore when we are clothed in Christ, then we are more than conquerors. The Christian faith stands or falls on the resurrection, and we want to thank God that the Christian faith is not failing. It is always rekindled, it's always brought some newness in it, and we find that this faith continues. Christian faith continues, and it continues to get strength day in, day out. We are doing that because Jesus, who is the author, who is the basis, is always walking with us. And even when he is not with us in the body, during that day of Pentecost, we were told that the Holy Spirit will be with us all through. I repeat again, if Jesus Christ did not rise from the dead, then we would not have any hope. But because he rose from the dead, then we have that hope in him. 1 Corinthians chapter 15, if you read verse 14 to 17, you hear that Christ's resurrection gave us that living hope. The substance of our hope. The substance of our hope is that we are an inheritance. You and me, those that God called through Jesus Christ, and we came to him, and he said there is no Jew, there is no Gentile. Them who accepted Christ to be their leader, we follow him, we become an inheritance. An inheritance is a benefit of a blessing which is given to somebody. It is due to the fact that all of us who have accepted Christ have become that inheritance, and we were born into the family of God. It is not earned, it is often not deserved, but Christ have decided just to make us his inheritance. And we are also men and women of inheritance. It is a possession that is ours out there, not only today, but is a possession for life. The inheritance a child of God enjoys is far greater and more substantial than any other earthly inheritance. And you know how people, they follow their inheritances always. But the inheritance that we have gotten ourselves It is an inheritance that nobody can deny us. It is incorruptible. It is an inheritance that is incorruptible. That means that this inheritance will never decay. It is something that will never at one time rot. So it is a very, very important inheritance coming from our Lord Jesus Christ. It is undefilable. It cannot be polluted. It cannot be ruined. Even by you, even by any enemy, that inheritance remains. If only you accept to walk in the Lord all through, it cannot fade away. It is ours forever. We cannot lose it. It cannot be stolen. So this inheritance is so important. And this inheritance is giving us that hope that is living. The word hope is commonly defined as a feeling of expectations and desires for a certain thing that is to happen. We hear people say, I hope we have something good to eat tonight or during lunchtime. I hope my boss is in good mood today. I hope. Quite a number of people talk about this hope. Hope is always looking forward, and it is important to have hope or to have a positive outlook on life, to hope that better things are coming our way. That is what the Lord tells us to have, even at this particular moment. Yes, life is very difficult. Quite a number of people are facing this challenge. COVID-19 has become a real challenge in our lives. But when we have got that hope, we are looking forward. We have that hope, and we have life, outlook on life, to hope for better things happening on a daily basis. And we live to know that what happened yesterday, then tomorrow it will be better than what was yesterday. We have a hope, and we have a tomorrow. To not have any hope during difficult times can make recovering that much more difficult or even impossible. So there are people who are lying there, but they are hopeless. They are living a life of hopelessness. We are calling all of us to increase, Lord, increase our hope. Increase us. Again, the people that are with you matters a lot. There are some people that you have taken. They might be people who will be increasing your hope. People who will often be people to comfort you. People who can help you and provide assistance in one way or another, that you remain in hope. When you are surrounded by such people, then your hope continues. And again, more than the people surrounding you, we are told the Holy Spirit will be our companion, so we will not be alone. And He will give all the support that we need to increase our hope. So our hope is built and based on certainty, not uncertainty. So not only the desires, not only what we are hoping for, but we are certain that these things will happen. Even now, we are not saying that we are hoping that tomorrow it will be better, that COVID-19 will maybe decrease. No, we are saying it will go. And we are certain of that. Living hope gives certainty. And we pray that our men and women, our communities,
will be able to see and to have this kind of faith, kind of hope, that it is a certain hope that things are happening, things are changing. The Lord says, I'm doing a new thing. That new thing will do away with the old one, will do away with the trials, will do away with the challenges, and will be in that hope that Christ is giving good things tomorrow. It will get more difficult when we see nothing but dark clouds or hardship in front of us. But men and women who are anchored, who are planted in Christ Jesus our Lord, they never see dark clouds. They never see difficulty situations ahead. We are the people who see the light at the end of the tunnel. We are the people who are always seeing victory. We see things happening. This is the way we need to go, brethren. We need to have that living hope as we continue with our day-to-day activities in our homes, in our businesses, because we are still in business. We still have hope that schools will open. We still have hope, and this is hope that is certain, that even churches are opening very soon. And therefore, because we are people of hope and people who have anchored their faith and their hope in Christ Jesus, then Christ is taking the battle on instead of us. Christ is taking our battles, and he will fight for us. And therefore, instead of having just desires or wish that things will change, that is why we are saying that because of Christ, our hope means certainty. A believer never has to worry about who will be around him or her to support, because over and above our friends, over and above our family members, Christ, through the Holy Spirit, is with us. He is a comforter and director, and he will continue to direct us so that we can be able to come out victorious on the other side. Brethren, we know that surely people, the world, and even those in the church, we are undergoing the same trials, the same temptations, the same challenges. Brethren, I want to say there is a difference. There is a difference. The hope that Christians have is that living hope. Hope that is certain, that things are changing, and they are changing for better. We are looking forward where Jesus takes the lead. Because we have become a family that is led by Christ himself. He has become the Lord and Master. He has become the managing director of our lives. And that is why we in that family are talking about the expectant hope. Expectant hope in Christ. It means that we are very eager for the future that is coming, and we are excited about what is coming. We can be expectant because we have absolute certainty in the promises that God has provided for us. And he says his promises are A and Amen. When he promises to do one, he brings that one to accomplishment. So whatever he has promised, and he has continued to promise to us that he is making all things new, he is again bringing newness even in our lives, then we have that expectant hope that that is what is happening. Therefore, brethren, we want to remember Paul when he was talking to his son Timothy in 2 Timothy chapter 2, where he was telling him to rekindle his faith. When he was telling Timothy not to let anybody despise him, when he was telling Timothy, take charge, take charge. The Lord is also talking to us today, and he is telling us to take charge. He is with us, and we will not be defeated. 2 Timothy chapter 4. Paul talked this boldly when he was talking about his life, and he was coming to the end of the life, and he said that I have done my race, I have fought my fight, I have finished my race, and I've kept the faith. Brethren, I want to urge all of us so that we can go the full mile, and I want to pray that you will keep to the faith. Keep to the faith. Let us not give up. Let us keep to the faith to the end, like Paul, and God is on our side. God is waiting to see us come to victory, and he is saying, well done. He also say, well done. So this COVID-19 is coming to an end. I'm certain. Of that living hope. The businesses are coming back in a very new way, better than the way they were before. We are going back to our shambas with crops getting yields more than we were getting before. We are coming back to the churches, and we will be able to worship God in the newness of the Spirit. Let us hope. Brethren, let us hold to that living hope. We will never be defeated. We are people that the Lord has made, people who always come to victory. Through him who conquered death, who conquered sin, and conquered Satan, and everything else. From being his family, we also conquer. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Our Father and our God, help us to hold to this living hope, even when the going is very tough. We know in you we have victory, and other people will say, truly, there is a mighty God. There is a mighty God who brings victory. Let us rise so that we can get our benediction. Go ye to the world. Hold this living hope. Never ever give up. And the peace of God that surpasses all human understanding, I want to pray that that peace will always accompany you, will always be with you. We pray that the blessings of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you now, remain with you, and continue with you now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Have a beautiful week. God be with you, and hold that living faith, expectant faith. Amen.